अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई एम मोहम्मद महमूद हसन, असिस्टेंट टीचर एग्रीकल्चर, ग्रीनफील्ड स्कूल एंड कॉलेज। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एडाप्टेशन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ क्रॉप्स टू सबमर्जेंस और फ्लड। वी नो दैट एक्वाटिक प्लांट कैन ग्रो इन वाटर, दे कैन सर्वाइव इन वाटर, but the plant that do not tolerate excessive water, they cannot survive. In this condition, the plant root cannot respire due to lack of oxygen in soil. The quicker the soil or soluble oxygen in the soil water become empty, the quicker the plant die. But we know that rice is a water loving plant. Rice plant has parenchyma tissue. Parenchyma tissue contains water in its body. Parenchyma tissue contains more air than water. So aren means air, parenchyma means air containing tissue. Rice plant has parenchyma tissue. This tissue has a lot of air spaces. Oxygen is stored in this air spaces. Consequently, if rice plants do not go under water fully, they can survive under flood or submergence and give good yield. But if submergence for long time, they die. The plant height of deep water rice increases with the increase of flood water. The internodes of plants of such rice varieties possess a kind of meristematic tissue which is divided quickly with the increase of height of flood water, and thereby increase plant height and face flood. Again, the tall varieties of rice can escape from flood due to their height. Adaptation mechanism of crops to high temperature. The rate of photosynthesis and respiration is decreased at high temperature. The rate of decrease in photosynthesis is more compared to that of respiration. In this condition, the protein of crop plants become degraded and water loss occurs. At high temperature, a special non-degradable protein is formed in the plants that are tolerant to high temperature. The high temperature tolerant plants can survive, can remove the broken protein from the body. Now, I want to give you a task. Read this task and do the task as following. The learners will write down the mechanisms of salinity, submergence and high temperature adaptation in their notebook and will present in class. So do this task in at home and you will present it online. Now I am going to start section 4. The title of section 4 is Effect of climate change on fisheries sector. In the previous class, I have discussed the effect of climate on crop. Now, I have to discuss the effect of climate on fisheries sector. Fisheries sector plays an important role to meet up the nutritional requirement, create employment opportunity, earn foreign currency, that means overall economic development of Bangladesh. Bangladesh possesses third position in the world for collecting fish from internal water bodies and possess fifth position for culturing fish. There is about 4.7 million hectare area of internal open and closed water body, including river, canal, bill, haur, pond, lake, tidal area, etc. in this country. Moreover, there is wide sea area of 1,66,000 square kilometer. Presently, fish production from these water bodies is not sufficient as compared to its area. More production can be possible from them. Presently, 2010-2011, fish production in this country is about 30.60 metric ton and target production is 34.78 metric ton up to the year of 2012-2013. Although fish production in this country has gradually been increased for last few years, and it is increased due to fish culture, but natural fish production in the internal open water bodies like river, canal, bill, haur, tidal land has been decreased drastically. Biodiversity of fishes is also decreased there, and this happens due to climate change. Climate change causes increase of environmental temperature, increase of surface height of sea, increase of salinity, absence or shortage of rainfall. Severity and number of cyclone and tidal wave is increased. For this reason, fish culture, natural breeding of fish and their movement is hampered. The effect of climate change on fisheries sector is described below. Effect on fish culture and fry production. In our country, farmers release fries in the seasonal pond if it is merged by rainwater in April to May. Climate change decreases rainfall or causes late rainfall. That's why fries releasing become late. Besides, pond is also dried out quickly after the fries are released lately. As a result, culturing period is reduced and small fishes are to be marketed before reaching their maturity. In this way, farmers are losing. Fish breeding and fry production in hatchery are inhibited due to increase of temperature and low rainfall, which are caused by climate change. In hatchery, fish does not give response for artificial breeding due to not getting favorable environment for breeding and high temperature. They do not release eggs even they bear in their belly. Eggs are being absorbed in the body. If fish release eggs, these are not fertilized or very less amount fertilized. Thus, climate change is hampering the fry production in the hatchery. Fisheries are easily affecting with the diseases due to high temperature in shallow pond, and rate of mortality is increasing. As a result, production is becoming less and farmers' income is decreasing. Water is getting less in culture pond due to low rainfall. As a result, farmers are spending much money for supplying water in the pond or farm. Severity and number of flood, cyclone, tidal wave is increasing due to climate change. That's why difficulty of farmers is increasing with the increase of amount of loss in fisheries sector. Fisheries are going out of the pond. Fishes are going out of the pond. Culture ponds in the coastal area may be merged due to the increase of the height of sea level. Effect on fish culture, fish production in internal open water body. Less water is found in water river due to low rainfall, and as a result, it is easily possible to harvest fish in low water. Thus, small, big, and matured fishes are being caught. As a result, biodiversity and permanent production of fish are hampered. Sea surface height is increasing due to increase of temperature, and that's why salinity is entering towards the mainland. In this way, natural breeding and living ground of freshwater for fish are decreasing in coastal area. At the same time, production is also decreasing. In Bill, however, tidal area of our country, month of April, May is the breeding period of native type small fish. In the recent years, water body is not merged by water till the month of July due to absence or low rainfall during rainy season. That's why fish breeding is being hampered greatly. As a result, this affects whole fish production and nutrition and livelihood of those people who are involved with harvesting fish. In our country, naturally, Rui types of fish release eggs only Halda River. They release eggs during heavy rainfall after extreme heat in the month of Boishakh. Then, fishermen collect fertilized eggs from the river and produce fries by hatching the eggs. Due to increase of temperature caused by climate change, eggs maturity of brood fish comes earlier. On the other hand, starting time of rainfall is gradually going backward. Thus, dissimilarity is observed between the physiological condition of fish and the time of rainfall. As a result, possibility of getting eggs is decreasing. Effect on marine fish. Carbon dioxide is increasing day by day in the air, and that's why temperature of air and sea level are increasing. So, movement of wind and nature of rainfall are changing. Hence, fish movement in the ocean and their production are affected. Thus, fish quantity may be increased in one part of ocean. Besides, the place which is popular for safe living for fish be fishless. Global warming and climate change cause the movement of fishes from tropical area to temperate area. Many fishes have already changed their migration route, breeding place and living space. As a result, the place of ocean where fishermen have been fishing based on their knowledge and experience since long past, if changes occurs to these places, they will fall in trouble. Coral reef is the suitable living place for marine fishes, where various types of fish live in and in is used as breeding place. Coral is being destroyed due to increasing temperature in water, variation of waves, increasing acidity in ocean, pollution, changes of wave speed, etc. Thanks for watching this video.